Hello, 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 and welcome to another episode of the Crazy Town Podcast. My name is Jonas. I'm your host, and I'm here with
TNT Dynamite Explosive One Jonas. We're doing a podcast. TNT Dynamite. What up, though?
Oh, you know, just hanging out.
Dude, there is no news, dude. All the news is about one thing, dude.
The situation.
It is so hard out here.
I know,
dude. The streets is dry.
Yeah.
The well is dried up, Jonas.
Just like...
It's like old, used up, just dusty, elderly
coffin dust
boobs.
Everywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah, so anyways, thanks for joining us on the Crazy Town Podcast. If you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel, Crazy Town Media, we have all the podcasts plus a bunch of gaming videos. So you should do that. Also, Spotify and iTunes, SoundCloud, all those motherfucking places to listen to us audio only, as our voices will melt your eardrums in the best way possible.
Let them know that the gaming videos is more of us.
The gaming videos is more of us.
Is this?
Just want to tell you.
Thank you.
He told me to let you know.
No, so I feel, yeah, good. Also, let them know that I think they're awesome.
TNT thinks you guys are awesome.
Mm-hmm. And let them know if they want to give something to our Patreon that they can.
If you want to donate, leave your email in the comments. We'll figure it out.
Wow. Just leave your bank information.
Yeah, just leave your credit card number. We'll do it up. So we're on episode 101, TNT. Last episode was a banger. 100th episode, dude. Mother effing hundo.
Yeah, it was real good.
We made it.
It was great, dude. We were there. It happened.
Yeah, boy.
Remember when you castrated yourself live on podcast?
Yeah, dude. It was great. Healed up real nice.
For the 100th episode?
Yep, dude. It was nice. Out there in the streets with a red hot poker in the taint.
Some gardening shears.
Yeah, dude. So, yeah, I just want to jump right into it. I have some uplifting stories for once.
Oh.
Are you familiar with nanoparticles?
I know what a particle is, and I know nano means small.
Essentially, I have two stories. They're two kind of quick hits. One is Michigan State University has created or been working with a nanoparticle. They call it the Trojan Horse nanoparticle.
Oh, that's a great name.
Right?
Makes me think of a virus automatically.
Yeah, right. And there's more testing to come. But basically what it does is this particle goes into your bloodstream. It finds heart plaque and it releases a drug agent which stimulates the monocytes and the macrophages mm-hmm. to eat and engulf the debris in the veins or in the chambers of the heart. So essentially, if you have a plaque buildup where you're about to have a heart attack, it can like eat it away.
It clears out your arteries. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, like that. I mean, that would save so many people's lives, like, because heart disease is real.
Is it a chemical?
It didn't really say. It was a very short article because I think they just discovered it.
Yeah.
So like, but they said more testing to come. But like, they think they figured out a way to stimulate those particles of your immune system to attack plaque and take it away.
That's pretty cool, actually.
Yeah, right? Like, I figure, like, how many people would that save? So many people have heart attacks, they don't even know they're at risk to have a heart attack, and they have a heart attack and die.
That's going to be our next step in evolution, man, is figuring out how to enhance our own bodies.
Yeah, dude. Cyborg
tits. We're already cyborgs.
Cyborg titties.
I don't. They would be cold and hard. I don't want
like a big bag of sand.
I don't want a cold hard boob.
That reminds me of like 40-year-old virgin. He's like, oh yeah, just like grab him like a feels like a big bag of sand. And they're like, have you ever touched a breast before?
Once or twice.
So another.
That reminds me, Jonas, that they're talking about sex dolls are going to be in a lot of homes.
Sex dolls?
Yeah.
Are they made out of human flesh?
That's weird, so I'm not going to acknowledge it. No, but they're saying it's like a lot of people are buying those sex dolls now, dude.
For the situation?
No, just period, dude. It's becoming more and more commonplace.
Like, okay.
Let
me throw a hot take out here about sex dolls.
What, Jonas?
Is it worth all the effort?
Have you ever had sex with a sex doll?
I have not.
No, Jonas, tell the people at home.
But like... It doesn't seem like it's worth the effort. Okay, if my two options are
worth the effort.
Listen,
I don't have to take it to dinner. Listen, I don't have to be nice.
No, no. Here's where I'm going. If my two options are pull out the sex doll,
yes,
do my thing,
yep,
clean it, put it away, Jones, or just like grab my hand, which is already attached to my body, do my business, and go to bed.
Yeah, but well, Jonas, that's always an option anyway. The sex doll is not to replace your hand; it's to replace the woman.
But
there's no way you're ever going to convince me. Look, I'm not advocating. I'm just playing devil's advocate.
I know, I got you.
But you're never going to convince me is that it's easier to obtain sex from a woman than it would be to obtain sex from a sex doll.
Well, yeah, I agree. I mean, you could just, like, if you have a sex doll, you're just like, hey, I'm going to have sex with a sex doll, and you do it.
Yep.
Well, that's not legal with women. Jonas, you have to, like, have consent.
The defense rests. I dropped microphone.
What about your hand?
What do you mean?
You could just use
your hand. I just told you that it's not a replacement for your hand.
Do you really think a sex doll feels like a woman?
Do you really think your hand feels like a woman?
But, I mean, the end result is the same.
I don't know what a sex doll feels with. I don't need that because I can get pussy.
You're going to name it? You're going to name it, too? Like, oh, Susan.
I mean, they have names.
Oh, they do? They come pre-named? Oh,
come on, Jonas.
I don't know.
They name dildos and fleshlights and stuff like some crazy names. So, of course, the sex doll, this is the Bridget model.
Oh, damn.
Oh, this is the Candace. So you're saying you're not going to get a sex doll?
No, I'm good. Take it to the family dinner and shit. Show up like she has like a, she has like, get her hair done all nice. Got a new wig.
The thing is that if I was assured that it felt as natural.
Okay. That might change the game. If somebody was like, you couldn't tell the difference between a real woman and the sex doll.
Then you're on board.
If you're like,
you're not wrong.
You're like, can we do a test run?
Can we test? It piques your interest a little bit more.
Yeah, like I think the reason a lot of people, it isn't so much that you're like fucking a doll. It's you're like, dude, it can't feel like you're fucking a woman.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's kind of the thing. It's like, it can't feel like I'm fucking a woman.
So you've never like tried a fleshlight?
No.
Which is essentially a fleshlight. It's a flashlight with a fake vagina insert, and you just kind of like...
It's like a flashlight with an orifice.
It kind of is.
It kind of looks like a...
It kind of is.
Vagina. For those of you who've never seen one, you can figure that out. You're on your
own. Don't Google it, though. You'll probably run into some bad stuff.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so they do offer those. I've heard amazing things about fleshlights. I'm good, though, right?
I would much rather just... use something I can throw away.
What do you mean?
Like a tissue or something.
You're jacking off with a tissue?
Like, no, but I mean, like, if you have to, like, go clean your stuff out of it, like, if you plant your seed inside a fleshlight, you have to clean it, dude. Like, you have a seed inside there that you have to, like, clean out.
You have a seed in there.
You're making a rope jungle gym in there,
like,
dude.
Like I'm just like ejaculating pumpkin seeds into this thing or something. No.
You got planted.
No, I get it. But I mean,
hey man.
Hey. I mean, lonely. You can pull out and use a tissue if you want.
Pull out with a fleshlight. What is the point of that?
I mean, do you pull out of your hand? Now see, the fleshlight, that replaces masturbation. The sex doll replaces
sex.
The woman, yeah, I guess.
I've been in the sex store before, the adult store, and they have like they're like half sex doll. It's just like the ass and the vagina and the hips. And oh. Like, how is that? You just like, how do you pretend that that's anything but like just like a?
Funny, Jonas. This is how you do it. You take a blanket, right?
Okay.
And then you put the thing. You put the. It's not a bust. What is it?
It would be like the op. It's like a. It's,
the opposite
is. Yeah, it's like the bottom half of
you
a bus.
You lay it, you put it on the bed, and then you wrap the blanket around so that it kind of looks like a person's like on one end.
Oh, okay.
And then you get behind it, and you just kind of like, boom.
That seems like a lot of effort.
It does.
Yeah. Okay.
I don't know, dude. I'm a sexual deviant, 100%.
Yeah, oh, I agree. Me too. But like,
not that bad.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm good.
Not to the where I just want to fuck silicone.
Fuck a silicone hips with a I'm good.
Yeah,
but it could be modeled after your favorite porn star.
Oh boy, my favorite porn star, huh? Well, let me get right on that.
Back to nanoparticles. The other.
Leave it to us.
The other. I know, we're going from like something very positive to like fuck dolls. Nanoparticles. They have also developed a spinal cord injury EpiPen that uses nanoparticles. But what this one does is it convinces the... Because what happens is when you have a spinal injury, it's your own body's immune system that makes you not able to get it repaired. Because it starts like cutting off things. But what this does is it confuses the immune system so it doesn't do that. So you get an extra window of time to get into surgery to get your back repaired.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. So, I mean, granted, you probably still don't have a high success rate, but like if you're like a mountain climber, you have a spinal EpiPen, you fall, dude, boom. It at least gives you extra time in case.
So I'm assuming that these are relatively new developments. They're probably not being widely used as of yet.
Right. I think they're still in testing, but animals and things like that. Yeah.
That's pretty cool. A lot of this stuff gets tested, though, and then like you hear about it happening and then you never hear anything about it again. Like I heard, I don't know if it was like last year, that they were making breakthroughs on the cure for cancer.
Right.
And then you hear nothing about it.
Yeah, I think that stuff takes so long. Because they cured a second person with HIV who like has been like, it's like they're on the precipice of some things that like, it takes a long time to do medical advances and to get it approved and like enough clinical tests and blah, blah, blah.
And then for it to spread, for people to get educated on it, then the doctors have to, cause it's just a lot, man. And like, I remember I even did the story about how they found, healing properties in platypus milk.
Oh yeah.
And then,
or they're gonna do where you hook your computer right to your brain and they do neurotransmitters for like people who have like
none of it. But it is very interesting to hear about.
And I think some of it like they kind of put out a little spec like, hey, we did, and then they're like, and then there's like a 5-year trial. Then so there's no news about it during a 5-year trial because it's all they're being trialed, you know?
Yeah. And if it doesn't get funded.
Right.
It doesn't get funded.
All right. I got another story to touch on because it's not nanoparticle related.
I mean,
you can relate to this one.
Wait, is this a black joke?
Wow. No. Holy shit. No.
No. What, Jonas?
Some people play a lot of Grand Theft Auto.
This is a black joke. What the hell, man? No.
You know, I know. I was friends with you when Grand Theft Auto Online came out. Yeah, you played a lot of that.
We did. I played.
You played a lot. Tons. I played a lot. Nowhere near as much as you, but.
Woo.
But yeah. So another story from across the pond in the old UK.
Oh, look at Jonas.
Lancaster, Blackpool, Florida.
International,
Florida.
Yeah, boy.
There was a child who played tons of GTA. He was 11 years old.
Mm.
So parents were tired of him clogging up their TV with Grand Theft Auto.
Okay.
They're like, little Billy, boy, I'm tired of you being out here in the streets playing Grand Theft Auto.
He was in the street playing it or in the living room?
In the streets, in the living room. Yeah, okay, same difference.
That's what they call them over there in the UK.
They call them in the house, in the streets.
They call
in the streets.
They call cookies biscuits. And
yeah, dude.
Living rooms the streets.
Exactly. I'm glad we're on the same page.
Shopping trolleys.
So if you were tired of your child playing Grand Theft Auto, what would you do to kind of to mend that fence?
Take the power cord from the Xbox.
Okay.
And or PlayStation.
What about something else, you think, maybe? What's something else you could maybe do? Getting him out, you take him outside, and what would you have him do?
Get a Switch so I could beat him.
You meant the Nintendo Switch, and I was like, how's that going to fix it? And then I got you meant like the old school, go pick your own Switch. It better not be too thin, because I'm going to go pick another one for you.
Yeah.
No. They took his ass to a parking lot and let him drive the car around.
Oh.
Because he was having too much Grand Theft Auto. He was just driving a car in a parking lot.
I mean, that's legal.
No.
Yeah.
So the cop pulls up.
It's not legal. But that
was legal. It's not legal. It's a public parking lot. They took their kid to the car. No, they don't have a license.
That's a formality.
Right. So, so the cops cited the parents. The parents got a ticket. Because they let their 11-year-old kid go to the parking lot and just drive the car around because he was doing too much.
Okay, wait a minute. He was doing it unsupervised?
I mean, I think the parents weren't in the car. I think the parents were like there watching him drive the car around by himself.
Why would they be out of the car?
Why would they let him drive in the first? It's not like he was sitting on their lap. He was driving the goddamn car. They just let him, like, they're like, I'm tired of you playing Grand Theft Auto. Go drive the car.
Okay. See, now the way I see it is that they were in the car. They were letting him drive. He was under supervision. I don't see a problem with that. It's 100% legal for me to do things with my child under my supervision. You can, like we were talking about, taking a child to the bar, getting them a drink.
Oh, yeah. Some places, yeah, you can do that if the parents are there. Yes. But no,
like, really, obviously, you can't get the child drunk because that's 100% illegal. It's child endangerment. But if you're in a vacant parking lot with a kid, you let him drive the car a little bit. I don't really see that as an issue.
What would Elon Musk do?
Does he have children? He does have children. Would build his own fucking parking lot.
He would just build a parking lot. That would solve it.
Build a safer car.
What's the dumbest thing you've ever seen a kid do?
I was just on Reddit, actually, before I came in here to record with you. And a child knocked on his door of his own home, and he had something he wanted to show his mom, and it was the decomposed carcass of a cat.
Oh my god!
And he was like, "I found it."
What did she do?
She was like, "What is that? What do you got?" She was freaking out, dude, because he was just like barehanding this. It was like decomposed, like. And the kid, she's like, drop it, and he drops it, and it just like dust.
Oh, yuck, dude. That's so. Why are kids so gross?
Because they don't fucking know any better, dude. They're not smart creatures.
Underdeveloped brains and shit.
Yeah, and it's hard for me to understand sometimes. Like, I definitely do have like, what are you doing, kid? What are you doing? Why?
Children are not the smartest.
You don't deal with kids too much, though, Jonas.
No, man. I haven't had to deal with kids much at all since I had stepchildren.
I mean, but even then, they were
teenagers.
Like, yeah, those aren't kids.
Yeah.
When's the last time you even dealt with a child?
Like, for an extended period of time or just for, like, a day?
I don't fucking care.
Well, when I was home in Ohio, we had a family gathering, and all the grandkids and stuff were there. So there was kids that were, like, 2 till, like...
Okay, so...
There was kids around and stuff.
But that was a long time ago. You haven't had a family.
Yeah, no, I went home in September.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Like, I had a family picnic, and all the grandkids and stuff were there.
See, and prior to my current situation, I couldn't even tell you, dude.
Yeah,
I
couldn't even Before that tell was you. Probably, God, where, like, I had to, like, well, I've hung out with a girl I work with and her husband. They have kids, so, like, their kids would be with us. We went bowling, and their kids were there. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, it wasn't like I was really, interacting very much with them. It was just like, hey, kid was there while we were eating dinner or whatever.
I don't really care for kids for long periods of time. Short bursts of kids, yeah. Man, they're all right.
That's
funny.
How I feel. I like kids a lot more when they're old enough and they can communicate with you. So, like, once they're about, like, 5.
You say that, but on the same note, Jonas, when they can't communicate, at least you don't have to hear their fucking stupid ideas.
Dude.
Because they got nothing important to say.
From the age of 5 till about 16, no. They have no important thoughts.
Not even then, dude. I feel like you don't have shit to say until you've hit like 20, 24.
Wow.
100%, because
you're
done
out there
nothing.
In the streets.
You've done nothing. You're still discovering everything. Everything is new. You got nothing. And yeah, that makes me sound like a fucking boomer. Fuck you.
Okay.
That was a boomer.
That was really. I was like, wow. The boom is loose.
Hey, fuck you.
You have a birthday. Next thing I know, you're booming on me, dude.
I'm just saying, Jonas. And you know it. You know it because you've held a conversation with a young person in the near past. They ain't got shit to talk about.
Oh, we didn't have to talk about a lot.
The only thing that kids have to talk about is their feelings, the music they listen to, and taking a shit. Because that's all they've done. They've felt things, they've listened to things, and they shit.
It is funny because I can tell when I'm talking to someone who's really young, because they're always like, what kind of music are you into? I'm like, that's only a question you ask someone if you're like under 25 years old.
Right?
Like, I don't ever, like, I haven't went on a date with anyone in the last 15 years that I went, what kind of music you like? Like, that's not what you talk about. Like, it just isn't.
What do adults tell on dates? What do they talk about? The news?
How you get up in them
guts. Does your dick still work?
Does your dick... So if I let you in my guts, are you gonna be able to...
Well, so... see, I don't get wet anymore.
So... Jesus.
So I keep a bottle of lube on me.
That's all right. I don't get hard anymore.
Well, we'll do just fine.
We'll just jam. Oh, never mind. Just stop now while I'm behind.
Yeah, old people dating.
Dude, can't wait till I'm old and dating.
I'm telling you, Jonas, man. I can't wait to be elderly. It's going to be great, man. I can definitely wait, but I'm cool with it.
Let's put it like that. You can do whatever you want.
You can say whatever you want.
Yeah. Oh, that's just TNT. He's from a different time.
Right? I'm from the 2000s.
He was born before 2000, folks. Oh, my God. Tell me what it was like before the new century.
I remember back in my day, you could call everybody an F word.
What? Oh, no. That's going to be you in the nursing home, just calling everybody words.
Just calling everybody words. I am not, no. I'm not going to let you paint this narrative that I'm a homophobe.
Dude, it could be any word.
I don't use homophobic slurs.
Wow. How did, wow.
Wow.
I didn't even know that's what we were talking about.
Yeah, I said the F word.
I know.
I didn't mean fuck, that's for sure.
Yep. But, yeah. On that note, man, TNT nursing home, mate. That's all the time we got for today's episode. Please.
Please. We're begging you.
Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel, Crazy Town Media. Like it, notify it. Spotify, iTunes, go to there if you want to hear our voices, because we very much will melt your eardrums to the point that it's like fudge. Does that even make sense?
No. I'm just letting you freestyle.
That's what I'm going for, dude.
Freestyle it. Yeah. Jonas will cry if you don't subscribe.
Oh, I've been, whew, story of my life. But for Jonas,
TNT Dynamite,
we'll catch you on the next one. For now, we are out.